inclusive culture. All students should feel like true members of their school, valued and accepted by their peers and teachers. In this video, we'll share some ideas to create a culture of inclusivity for every student in the school community.
The objectives are mindset of our kids, ownership by everyone, a belief that all kids can learn, and peer friendships and respect for relationships. Kids are all just kids. Mindset of our kids. Watch Lisa Livingstone, principal of North Carroll Middle School, talk about accepting students in the Our Kids mentality.
My old school way of thinking, where I would think, well, my kids farm out, or they go out into these programs, or they go out into classes when appropriate for their learning. And in this building, they are our kids. They are in general ed homerooms. They are in general ed flex groups. Very much accepted here. And I even hear teachers say our students. They don't say, well, those kids are your students or alt framework students. They just say our kids.
Mindset of our kids. Students should feel accepted and at home in their classrooms. Listen to Karen Scott, special education teacher, discuss inclusion in their school.
I think that taking the time to build that understanding and build that shared vision is what has made it more successful than I've seen in many other settings.
A belief all kids can learn. Inclusive schools work to promote the true abilities of each and every student. Listen to April Tompkins, 7th grade science teacher, describe how she is successful teaching in an inclusive way.
Being part of an inclusive school has been an awesome experience. And I think that, I don't know if it's changed so much my teaching style, but my attitude, I think, in teaching is, it really helps me to believe even more just that every student can learn. If you have the right supports, the right people, the right resources in place, any student can learn.
A belief all kids can learn. Listen to Bruce Verbis, EC Instructional Support Staff member, reflect on the goals of inclusive education.
The biggest goal was to help them understand that they are competent learners, that they can learn just like anybody else. They're no different. They're a student in this school.
Peer friendships and respect for individuals. Another critical component of inclusion is encouraging peer interaction. Nick, a 6th grade student, speaking about his relationship with classmate AJ.
He learns a different way than everybody else, and that's what makes him so unique and interesting and fun to learn with. Reading, he learns with pictures instead, and that it clicks more to him. And for me, that clicks for me a little bit more than reading.
Amber, a 7th grade student.
Yeah, I really like all the kids here, and they like treat you like you're like you belong here, and it's very awesome.
Jack, a 7th grade student.
Do your friends ever help you learn?
No, my friends, sometimes.
How do they help you learn?
How do they help me? By supporting me,
if I
need them.
And how do you help them learn?
By helping them back, if I need them, if they need me to support them.
Are you interested in learning more about inclusive strategies? Visit the TIES website to find more information on the topics listed.
The topics are the power of peers and creating communities of belonging.